I started listening to this podcast that talked about what was going on with family separation, and there was several consoles that were being interviewed on that podcast, and I started crying, and I said I really want to help in some way instead of. And I remember this clearly because I was washing dishes and I was listening to this podcast, and I'm like, I wish I would be doing something more meaningful than what I'm doing right now.
Effective immediately, individuals arriving in or entering the United States from Mexico, illegally or without proper documentation, may be returned to Mexico for the duration of their immigration proceedings.
What they believe is that if migrants know that they will have to wait in Mexico for months or even years before they're allowed to enter the United States, that they will decide against making that journey to the United States.
It's not entirely clear where these hearings are going to be. The thing that is clear is that there really aren't very many immigration lawyers who are in Mexico right now.
For this first people that we're gonna see, she's a lady that was raped in front of her daughter, and the little girl was raped also where they're staying at. So we're gonna ask for the non-refoulement, which means it's like the it's like the credible fear of Mexico, of being returned to Mexico after court. The second, it's a lady that should stay in the country on humanitarian reasons because she has a medical condition. She has recurring UTIs and she's pregnant. And then her husband is epileptic. So they should get proper medical attention. And obviously what they're staying at, the shelter that they're staying at, there, they have the food that is given to them. It's not good for them to get well and better.
What is a preconceived idea you had about immigration before you came to Las Vegas?
It wasn't a big deal. It was easy. And it's not. It's very difficult. It's very long. And sometimes it's very sad.
Do you feel like the work you're doing is making a difference?
I do.
Why?
Because I see it every day, and clients, you know, they thank you for sometimes what you think it's little or nothing. Even just listening to their story or listening to them, and they thank you, and I think that really makes a difference, having someone to at least listen to what has happened to you and that it's not fair. I think it's a good start.
Yeah.